Hi there and welcome to Catchment of Resources. This is Viro. This is part of the video series on Open Fast. This is part 4. In order to watch the previous series, you can actually check out the video links in this channel. Here we are going to look at how to edit the different files in Open Fast in order to carry out your own analysis on different blades or if it's the same blade as was defined in Open Fast. Wind energy technology is a very broad subject, and there are various institutions and online platforms that have already put up a lot of literature on it. There are several videos on YouTube as well as online platforms which I have linked above in order to search for various wind energy courses. But here I will go straight and talk about some certain concepts in wind energy technology prior to going over understanding how to do an input in Open Fast. There are various ways through which the wind turbine system can be rotated. One of them is the rotation of the yaw. When you are talking about yaw rotation, you are talking about the rotation of the wind turbine head itself. It could be done in the horizontal direction or in the vertical direction. When done in the horizontal direction, it's actually in order to face directly the incoming wind. And when it's done in the vertical direction, it's possibly in order to increase the allowance for deflection of the blade so it doesn't touch the tower. Another local rotation is that has to do with the pitch. For example, you have a wind turbine blade. In some systems, you are able to actually rotate it in order to regulate the amount of wind forces going on top of the blade. For example, in periods of extreme wind speed, which is far above what the wind turbine is designed for in order to generate power, in those cases you may need to rotate the blades to further position. So those are some of the two ways in which there's rotation in the wind turbine system. One of them is the yaw and the other is the pitch rotation. As you can see from this vector diagram of the different directions based on the wind speed, the angle of attack and the different lift and drag forces, you can see the influence of the wind speed based on direction. This has been taken from Wind Energy Explained textbook. So with respect to the twist of a blade, there are different blades that often are designed and are not just different segments of airfoils that follow a straight pattern. In this drawing, you can see here in the last figure, where you have the different colors of airfoils from the largest to the smallest. In reality, these are going to deviate based on angle because they are going to be rotated in order to capture more wind speed. Because when the wind is approaching a wind turbine blade, as the blade is rotating, there is some angle variation and the wind may not be optimum as when it was initially hit by the wind. As you can see here, according to this literature online, where it talks about 5 to 10% more energy is captured when you have a blade twist. There are different glue codes and test cases and modules which have been designed by National Renewable Energy Laboratory for the Open Fast. And within this, you are able to select different configurations, whether you want onshore, you want offshore, or you want a monopile or a spar kind of foundation. So different codes have been already inbuilt in order to work with Open Fast. There are several files, and just to mention two here to describe them. When you see sort of like 5 megawatt LAN BDDLLW tub, it may, for some people who are just beginning to understand Open Fast, it may seem like, what does this mean? So basically, you have a description here of it talking about the 5 megawatt turbine, which is land-based, and the other 5 megawatt turbine, which is an OC4 jacket, a four-legged jacket, which is an offshore system. You'll be able to find out how you can actually find the meaning of each of these test cases and modules in order to know whether it suits your current desired design. So this is actually on the Open Fast repository, and you'll see all of the glue codes and test cases listed here. So you can always go select each one of them and find out the description, what is actually being explained. So it's possible to actually select one of them and you will see it being explained what it actually means, test case based on OC4 jacket. For those who want more information, you can always select each of these details and Google it, as we always do. For example, if you search for an OC4 jacket, what it looks like, and you search online, maybe you want a video and you go for a YouTube video, you can see an example of an OC4 offshore jacket. There are different information which can be obtained, because some of this information, because it's a complex application, it may not be easily accessible, but some of these ways are ways in which people can quickly understand what it entails and how it can be used. Also, aside looking at the details of what is explained in the README, you can also look at the results when you actually run the application. From the results, it can also tell you the kind of structure. For example, if you have a monopile and if you have a jacket, the kind of results data you will obtain are going to be different. And a monopile is going to be giving you a singular information, while a jacket will give you multiple members with different stress information. So aside looking at the details and explanation, you can also look at the results to find out exactly which kind of structure is supporting the wind turbine system. Basically, if you are going to be designing a different wind turbine system, you need to actually look at the configuration for the definition for this open fire system. For example, there's a certain distance between the tower and the tip of the wind turbine blade. For a smaller blade, that distance is going to be lower, and for a larger blade, the distance is going to be higher. So it all depends on what you want to use as your own control prior to the design, in order to control the design, because based on the stiffness of the blade, if the deflection is excessive, the program is going to fail when running. So it's best to provide an allowance, even though it may not be the actual value. And then once you have gotten your deflection and all those values, they are now able to use those values in the design of the actual turbine system. The concepts of offshore wind turbine technology is based off the old oil and gas offshore technology. For example, the different foundations being used for wind turbine systems is based on what has been used for several years for the design of offshore oil and gas facilities. It's just been modified in order to carry the weight and the peculiarities of wind turbine systems. So you are just selecting based on what you have. For example, you have here a monopile, four-legged jacket, a four-legged spar. There are also three-legged spars as well. So we need to actually know which exactly we are selecting for design based on the environment in which it's going to be installed. Basically, in order to edit OpenFast, there are several files which are mostly the .dat files, which are the data files. When it comes to editing OpenFast, the 5 megawatt baseline, that's sort of like a test case. It's not really a test case, it's actually the basic folder in which all the data, all the input data for all the other test cases are based off. All the different test cases, for example, the land-based wind turbine or the four-legged jacket turbine systems, they all base their input from the 5 megawatt baseline, although they also have some information to edit in their own folders, but majority of the information is taken from the 5 megawatt baseline. When it comes to changing the property of the wind turbine blade, it's possible you want to change the airfoils, or you want to change the lift and drag coefficients. Most information for airfoil is based on laboratory experiments which have been done in the past, or you need to do. It can also be done on CFX using software. But there's also online platforms which also provide airfoil information, airfoil data. I'll show it subsequently. You can actually obtain that in airfoiltools.com. So you see, when you open the folder for the 5 megawatt baseline, you can see all the files in case you want to change any information. I would advise that, because there are usually instructions in OpenFast that tells you you cannot remove a line or add a line. You can only edit the information in that line. So it's good to look at the information and instructions already available in OpenFast. If you look here at the beamdyne.dat file, the key points in the Z direction of the radius, you can see that the values are varying these values actually stand for, it can be edited, they actually stand for the distance along the blade. There are some input files that will talk about a fraction of the blade. You don't need to edit fractions, but when you're talking about the real value of the blade length, if you are doing a different blade as opposed to what has been primarily designed in OpenFast, then you will require editing of the beam dyne dot dat. So you'll be required to edit the beam dyne dot dat file because it's actually real values of the blade. You also need to edit the aerodyne dot dat file because the values are also real values of the wind turbine blade radius and some other information like the twist and the location of the center. This information, if you are doing a new blade, you will need to change some of this information. But things that have to do with fractions will not need to be changed. Also, like in offshore oil and gas, you also have requests for changing the thickness of ice, marine growth, and other information in the offshore environment. You can see here a badge. You can also see here a spar. You can see from the column of the spar to the lower section where you have probably a three-legged or a four-legged spar, the different coordinates. So for those who are not yet conversant with this, it's best to look at the results and understand the results before you know, okay, you say you, and also to visualize, yes. Once you also visualize with OpenFast, you are then able to know you want to change the configuration to a certain characteristics based on what you understand when it's visualized. So I spoke of this earlier. This is airfoiltools.com. You can find data for different kinds of airfoil. So in case you want to update what is available in OpenFast, you can change the lift and drag coefficient, as well as you have the X and Y coordinate values of how to draw the airfoil or to generate the airfoil profile. It's available in that website, but there are also other reliable sources like NACA. So when it comes to the main test case you want to work on, for example, if you want to work on an OC4 semi wind turbine system or a land-based wind turbine system, they also have their own input files, which is different from the 5 megawatt baseline. You can see in the input files, all the .dat files are also input, as well as the .fst. You can see where there's information required to be input if you want to vary it. Also, the aerodyne here, though, that is different from the aerodyne in the 5 megawatts. You have less information to update here compared to 5 megawatts, as I said earlier. So that's basically how to edit, and you are going to run it based on how it was done in part 1 of this video series. Thank you for watching this video. This is Catchment of Resources, where we create for better living.